Look, I want to just briefly show you how we communicated, because it really gives a lot of insight into the kind of creativity and originality that we all had to bring to our lives there in prison. We communicated by tapping on the walls. We used something called tap code, of course, tapping on the wall. And it is based upon 25 letters of the alphabet. We throw out the letter K, because you can use a C most of the time, it's the same sound. Then you arrange those remaining 25 letters in five rows of five letters each, one row on top of the other. As you're looking at it, it would be A through E in the top row, F through J in the second row, and then the third row of five, the fourth row of five, and the fifth row of five, putting C in the lower right-hand corner. That gives me five horizontal rows and five vertical columns in the same square, right? Isn't that high tech? A is up in the corner, first row, first column. If I want to tap, I hand the wall, I tap. Once for the row, once for the column. So A is one and one. B is in the first row, but the second column over. One and two. C, first row, third column over. One and three. F, second row, first column. Two and one. M is right in the middle of the square, third row, third column. And Z, way down here in the lower right hand corner, there would be. Right on. I want to tap out the word St. Paul. Yes. T. E. A. U. L. How about McCain? M. C. C. A. I. N. McCain. How about America?
Wow.
So it is that communication.